Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Equation of a Circle Part 5, and we do the following problem on this video. All right, here's our problem. Write the equation of the circle in standard form. State the center and radius and graph. Well, what's nice thing is that we're told that this is a circle, so that's easy. This is the equation of a circle in general form, so it doesn't tell us the center or the radius. And that's exactly why we're being asked to put it in standard form first. So what we do is we're going to use the completing the square. We're going to put the x squared and x term together. So we have x squared plus 4x. And we're going to have to add something to get a perfect square. Then we're going to put the y squared and the negative 6y together and add something to make it a perfect square. And we're going to put the constant on the other side by adding 12 to both sides. All right, so if you add 12 to both sides, we have equals 12. Now, both of these things that I'm going to be adding on the left to make it a perfect square, I like to always write down plus blank plus another blank so I don't forget I'm going to have to add something to the right side as well. So I'm going to come down and I'm going to figure out what the perfect squares would be. All right, so I have x squared plus 4x. Remember how this works. You have an x here. And since it's a plus 4, you're going to, for the coefficient of x, we're going to take half of that. So what's half of plus 4? It's plus 2. 2 squared is what goes on the blank. So what we're doing is we are adding 4 to both sides. All right, we also have to complete the square with the y's, right? So we have y squared minus 6y plus something. We're trying to figure that out. So again, we've got to put y. The coefficient is minus 6, so we take half of that. That'll be minus 3. So to make it a perfect square, that would be 3 squared. 9 is what I have to add to make that a perfect square and make it equal to the same thing as y minus 3 quantity squared. So I'm adding 9 to both sides. So what do I have on the right-hand side? I really have 12 plus 4 plus 9, which is 25. And I've just written that equation in standard form, or you can write it as equal 5 squared. If you write it like that, then you could see the radius as well. It's got to be 5, right? I'm writing 25 as something squared. So what is the center of the circle? Negative 2, right? You'd have to put in negative 2 for x to make what's in parentheses 0. That's one way of thinking about it. And 3 will be the y value. So this is my hk. That's my center of the circle. And my radius is 5. So if I want to graph this circle, right, that's a lot easier now to graph. I'm going to have to put small things here. 8, there we go. It's 8, that's 8. It's best if you have real graph paper, so looks a little better than mine. All right, so we've got negative 2, 3 is the center. So I'm just going to put a little dot here, but remember that is not part of the circle. To get the circle, you've got to go the radius in all four directions. So we're going to go 5 to the right. That's part of the circle. Okay, you're always going from the center. The center is negative 2, 3. We're going to go up 5. Go to the left 5. And we're going to go down 5. And we could get a rough sketch. Now another thing you can do is figure out where it crosses the x and y axes. I didn't ask you to do that, but let's figure that out. What are the x-intercepts You're going to let y equal 0, correct? This is just good practice with algebra. So you can either plug in 0 into the standard form of the equation, or you could plug in it into the equation up here, right? The general form. All right, I don't know which is going to be easier. Let me do it in the general form, in the top one. So what happens if we put in 0 for y? What would I get? I'd have x squared plus 0 squared plus 4x minus, I'm putting in 0 for y, 6 times 0 minus 12 equals 0. So what does that give me? That gives me x squared plus 4x minus 12 equals 0. And if I can factor it, that would be awesome. I think I can. I think it's x plus 6 and x minus 2 equals 0. Is that correct? I think so. So x is negative 6 or 2. So that's two ordered pairs. One of the ordered pairs would be negative 6, 0, and the other one would be 2, 0. Now, why would you do this? Only if you want to be a little bit more accurate when you're graphing the circle. So now I just know two more points. I've got negative 6, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's one of the ordered pairs. And I've got 2, 0. So in other words, it just helps me in doing the sketch a little bit more. And also, it's sort of symmetric across the center line right here. Can you sort of imagine the center line across where the center of the circle is? So there's going to be another one right up here. There's going to be another one right up here. It just helps you make some guides. You could also do the same thing by plugging in 0 for x into this equation, and then you're going to figure out what the y-intercepts are. Okay, so let's go ahead and now we're going to plug in. Here we go. To get the y-intercepts, you're going to let x equal 0, right? So let's go up here. We're going to put in 0 for x. Now, when it's going to be 0, I'm just going to make it disappear. So if I put in 0 squared, that's 0. So I end up with y squared. This term's gone, the plus 4x, right? And then I've got minus 6x, I mean 6y, minus 12 equals 0. And let's see, does that factor? I don't think that one's going to be as easy. So for this one, it's not that simple to do. You would have to use the quadratic formula to find out those y coordinates. Okay, so I'm not going to do it. You could use the quadratic formula to solve for y. The other thing you could do is you could have plugged it into the y. You could have plugged in x into in right here. So let's do it there. See if it's any easier. Right, so we're going to plug in 0 for x into that equation right there. So I'm going to get you 2. When you put in 0 for x, everybody with me, you're going to get 2 squared because 0 plus 2 is 2. So you're going to get 2 squared plus y minus 3 squared equals 25. And 2 squared is 4. So if I just subtract 4 from both sides, I get y minus 3 squared is, what's 25 minus 4? 21. And I'm just going to take the square roots of both sides. And you could see if I were to use the quadratic formula, I would get the same thing. 3 plus or minus the square root of 21. So if I did this, I'd actually have to take out my calculator. And I'm going to approximate this. So we want to put in the square root of 21, which is approximately 4.6. Okay? So let's see, if you did 3 plus 4.6, you'd have 7.6, right? And if you did 3 minus 4.6, it would be negative 1.6. So what does that mean? On your y-axis, you would have 7.6. Well, it's really close up here. Or you would have negative 1.6, which is about right here. It gives you not too many more points. So usually you don't want to go through all that hassle, but you should know how to do it anyway. You should know if somebody asked you what the x and y intercepts were, you should be able to go through that process. So the simple thing, of course, is just to do these 4 points here and sketch it, fairly well, and you're done with the problem, which is all I really asked for. So I'm just kind of catching you up on your algebra here, right? So the directions were write the equation in standard form, state the center and radius and graph, and we did it. But if the directions had been, what are the x and y intercepts? We actually went and computed them, so let's just write down what they really are. The x intercepts, those were the easy ones. Remember negative 6, 0, and 2, 0? And the y intercepts were the crazy ones. That's when you put in 0 for x, what'd we get? Now, I don't want the approximate. It's 3 plus radical 21. Right? Which does approximate to 7.6, but the actual y-intercept is 0, 3 plus square root of 21, and the other one is 3 minus square root of 21 for the y-coordinate. So sometimes you're also asked for the x-intercepts and y-intercepts, and just as a reminder, that's how you would do it. You put in 0 for x to get the y-intercepts, put in 0 for y to get the x-intercepts. All right. So, on to the next video, and we'll work with some more problems like this. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.